going on? In this video, I'm going to share with you what your curl hydration level is and what that means, what ingredients you need to be looking for specifically for your hair, your curls. So stay tuned. All right, guys, so there's four factors that determine your curl hydration level. Number one is porosity. Number two, thickness. Number three, how does your hair respond when you apply a moisturizer to your hair? And then number four, how long can you go without moisturizing your hair? Can you go longer than 4 days, 3 days, 1 day? So this is gonna help you determine what that level is, if you're level one, two, or three. So you might be curl hydration level number one. If your hair is low porosity, if you're kinda on a thinner side, like your hair's not that thick, and you really can go about 4 or 5 days without moisturizing your hair and your hair is good. So if that is you, what you wanna do is stick with lighter oils. You don't wanna do nothing too heavy because you want to avoid buildup. That's what you don't want. So stick with oils like jojoba oil, sweet almond oil, coconut oil, thinner conditioners, light conditioners will be your go-to surfactants to look for or ingredients to look for in conditioners and moisturizers. Things like cetyl alcohol, satyral alcohol will be great for your hair, very moisturizing, and it won't cause any buildup. So next is CHL number two. If you are in CHL number two, which is my category, you will have low porosity hair, rarely high porosity, but mainly low porosity hair. Now, when it comes to product, when you apply moisturizer to your hair, at first it looks like it's just sitting on top, but as you massage it, it will eventually absorb into the hair. And the kicker is you can actually go about two or three days without moisturizing your hair and you're okay. So my recommendations, we can actually do the heavier oils. We can do olive oil and sunflower and castor oil. Aloe vera juice is our best friend because it's a wonderful humectant. It's gonna draw that moisture into the hair. And I will say this, just a quick tip. When it comes to spraying our hair with water, low porosity CHL2 people, a lot of times it seems like it's just sitting on top of our hair and it's like little balls of water. Quick tip, mix your water in the spray bottle with some conditioner, shake it up and spray it, and what's going to happen is the surfactants inside the conditioner are actually going to help the water adhere and absorb into the hair. So surfactants are like a whole nother video, but it's amazing. Right, and last but not least, CHL3. If this is you, you would typically have thick hair, high porosity hair, and you really cannot go longer than a day without moisturizing your hair. You know you are in this category when you just like applied moisturizer and then like 10, 20 minutes later, it's like super dry again. Here are some recommendations. Number one, layers. You need to be all about layering. When I say layering, I mean you just wash your hair, you just condition. Next, leave-in conditioner, moisturizer, sealant. Now, whatever your sealant is, it needs to be something heavy. It needs to be an olive oil, a sunflower, a castor oil, because you need to seal in that moisture so that your hair can retain that moisture. Secondly, I'm gonna say protein is your best friend because with high porosity hair, the reason why you have to moisturize your hair so much is because you have cracks in your hair. There's missing gaps on the scales of your hair, so the protein is gonna come and fill that in and really restore your hair. They stay away from humectants because humectants will tend to lift up the hair. Your hair scales are already lifted. You don't need any more lifting, okay? And then also, apple cider vinegar is great for closing the cuticles. Only thing about that, I know a lot of people don't like the scent, you know, but another recommendation is called Rowe Porosity Conditioner. It has a pH level of 4.5, which is amazing for our hair. So basically, you want to focus on sealing those cuticles and rebuilding your hair with a good protein conditioner. And yes, I do believe that you can go from high porosity to low porosity. You can definitely do that. So that's all, folks. So yeah, so that's CHL3. That is all the curl hydration levels and whatnot. I hope that this video has been super helpful for you. If you have any questions, let me know. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. And make sure that your notifications are on so you can watch more science-based cosmetic chemistry natural hair loving videos from yours truly. And yeah, thank you for being here. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys soon. Okay, bye.